Parang may bago sa'yo. Di nga. Anong nagbago? There's something new about you. Have you looked at the mirror? Well, it's not just physical, but inside. Have you reflected na merong pagbabago nangyayari? Dito sa lockdown na meron tayo, crisis na meron tayo, still, something new is happening within us and around us. And in today's episode of Lighthouse, we're gonna discover that we have the opportunity to shift to generosity. We are called not just to be blessed, but to become a blessing as well. Sabi ko na nga ba eh, may nagbago sa'yo. And the reason why I'm sharing that with you is because, yes, napansin niyo ba? If you were able to catch yung mga videos natin before, nag-iiba rin yung somehow, the way I look. And yes, may unti-unting pagbabago, hindi lang panlabas. Hindi ba napansin? Bagong gupit ako, yan. Salamat sa aking pinakamamahal. Her name is Emeline, ang aking asawa na nang gupit nito. O diba, no choice, but still, by the grace of God, nakasurvive ako. Hindi lang ng crisis, but at the same time, sa paggupit ng aking asawa. Kaya, thank you, Milan. I love you. Anyway, back to our sharing. No, napakalagang tingnan natin na for the past videos, no, we were able to discover the 4 G's. The first one is gratitude, pagpapasalamat, that we are blessed. The second one is that we are good inside and out. Huwag natin kakalimutan yun because God made us good. The third one is growth. That we should have a growth mindset, that there's always an opportunity to grow. The biggest room in the world is the room for improvement. And finally, we're gonna talk about the last one, and that is shifting into generosity. Hindi lang tayo mag-shrink, di ba? Yung magdadamot. But we're gonna shift now into generosity. And maybe some of you are asking, in this time we're in, medyo talagang gipit na gipit tayo, di ba? How can you give to charity if you're a charity case yourself? And my dear friend, this is also the best time for us to really look at the opportunities that we can do so that we can help others. But yun na nga, you cannot give what you do not have. Mahirap magbigay ko, ikaw mismo, walang ibibigay. But I want to invite you to take a deeper look of how important generosity is in our lives, the importance of giving in our lives, my dear friends, because I want to share this with you. Life is a balance. And let me prove that with this simple activity. So wherever you are right now, even if you're watching with someone, okay lang, subukan natin ito. Again, pagbigyan niyo ako. Can you all do this? Everyone, take a deep breath. Inhale. 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 Ah, parang hirap, di ba? Baka mamaya, no, mautot ka pa. Anyway, di ba? Mahirap na mag-inhale. Tanggap ka na tanggap. How about this? Subukan natin. This time, second round. Exhale. 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 O, di ba? Parang nananakot lang, parang horror movie lang. But really, it's also, hindi pa pwedeng puro exhale lang, no? And I believe that's how important that we look and we embrace life as a balance. We inhale, and we exhale. Once again, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. When we inhale, it shows that we are receiving. We need to receive. When we exhale, we need to give. And that's how important life is. Hindi pa pwedeng tanggap ka lang ng tanggap. Hindi pa pwedeng taker ka lang. Hindi pa pwedeng, di ba, you're just a receiver. We are all invited to become a giver, to become a blessing to other people. And I love this by Winston Churchill. Sinabi niya, we make a living by what we get. But we make a life by what we give. And alam nyo, when we look around us, yes, maraming negative news, maraming mga nangyayari sa paligid natin, but there are stories of generosity. Aminin nyo yun. Maybe you yourself, you have your own story of generosity. Ako, I just want to share with you 3 stories of generosity as I look around, see it on social media. One of them, my dear friends, is yung story ng kaibigan ko na meron siyang linisan ng sapatos. That's his business. His name is Paul, and of course, because of the lockdown, naapektuhan yung negosyo nila. Wala sila ngayong operations, and yung kanyang mga empleyado talagang in need na. And alam nyo, nakita ko yung post niya na yung isa sa mga precious, you know, possession that he has. It's a signature shoe. signature nino ni Stephen Carefree lang naman, no? At saka nandun yung mga yung asawa niya, yung anak niya, talaga nakapirma yung buong pamilya, and it was so precious, but he's actually selling it so that yung pagkaakitaan nun, pangtulong niya sa pamilya ng kanyang staff. That's a story of generosity. There's another friend of mine, I'm sure nag-viral possibly ito. Nakita niyo yung superhero na Spider-Man in Infinity Spider-Man. Tapos nagbibigay ng mga pagkain sa mga nangangailangan, no? And I posted that. I even asked there a question, how can we become heroes in our own way? And nag-message sa akin yung kaibigan ko, his name is Monty. At si Monty naman sabi niya, bro, kilala ko yung nasa Spider-Man. Hindi ako yun, pero yan ay nag-arkila nung aking mga Spider-Man, no, na costume. Tapos alam mo, nung nalaman ko na mamimigay siya ng mga, di ba, relief or pagkain sa mga mahihirap, hindi ko na siya siningil. It's my way of paying it forward. That's another story of generosity. One more, isa pa, magbibigay ako sa inyo. You know, there's this one servant in our community, particularly the name of our community is The Feast, no, by the Light of Jesus Family. And yung servant na ito, hindi kami madalas nagkikita, pero he would every now and then message me sa Facebook Messenger. Tapos, he's saying to me, ang pangalan niya is Chin, Brother JC, Coach JC, I'm praying for you right at this very moment. Tapos, mapakita niya yung listahan ng mga ipinagdadasal niya. So, grabe! I was really blown away. Of course, these are packets of stories of generosity, pero alam natin na marami pang gumagawa ng kabutihan during this time. Huwag natin isipin na maraming taong maramot. Baka nakalimutan natin that there's a lot of people who are just generous. In fact, you are generous. Just maybe by sharing this, no, ating video to people, because ang dami ng negative news, you are now sharing something of value and positive sa maraming tao. And I want you to continuously celebrate stories of generosity. In fact, your own story of generosity. And alam mo, dahil na-experience ko yung lahat ng magbibigay na to, and for the past weeks, I've been going online, receiving a lot of content, natututo ko, I'm learning from different groups and different personalities, how they're doing the online platforms, virtual events. Sabi ko, now it's my time as well to give. Kaya for the past weeks, hindi lang po ako nag-go online para mag-social media o manood ng, di ba, mga streamings. Ako po ay nagbibigay ng mga webinars, ng mga workshops, ng mga trainings, and most of them are pro bono. Pag sabihin pro bono, puro abono. But, you know, ang pinakamasaya doon is yung nakapagbigay ka ng inspirasyon, ng encouragement, ng pag-asa sa ibang tao. And in fact, no, I'm excited because I'm going to have this online summit. It's a charity summit called #GrowBeyondCrisis, wherein pagkasama-samahin ko yung mga kaibigan, kakilala ko, the people that I look up to, thought leaders, influencers, difference makers. Magkasama-sama kami, we're going to have exclusive interviews. Tapos, we're going to launch it, no? Particularly, April 30, May 1 and 2, tatlong araw yan. Tapos, we're gonna invite the public to watch this, and they're gonna have it for free, at least for that next 3 days. But kung gusto nilang unlimited na mapanood nila, just in case busy sila, then we'll give that opportunity for them to donate sa mga mercy ministries that we have in the Light of Jesus Family. And that also includes yung mga efforts na ginagawa namin para sa aming mga frontliners. So, because I got to receive a lot of blessings, a lot of wisdom from people who's doing something online, now it's my turn to give as well. At gustong-gusto ko to, sinabi ni Anne Frank, no one has ever become poor by giving. So my dear friends, the more that we give, the more that we become blessed, and the more that we become truly rich. Tamang-tama, and this is my encouragement for you. If you want to have that life of abundance, of blessings, you make a decision to share your 3 T's. Ayan ha, tatlong letter T. Ano-ano yun? Time, your talent, and your treasure. Pag pinag-usapan ng time, my dear friends, we have all the time right now. And maybe that one short call sa kaibigan mo, kamustahin mo siya. Maybe that time with your family, no, bonding with them, homecation, no, that makes a lot of difference. That also includes, no, yung ating opportunity para ano, para tayo ay magbigay ng ating talent, no. I know of some people that they have the talent in music and they play. And then they play the guitar, someone sings, and then they have this opportunity to have giving donations, a charity na chosen nila, and they're really doing well, no? The likes of Ayo Barcelona, si Isa Rodriguez, I've been seeing them, no? Doing this online gig, and I'm sure marami pa. So just share your talent, and even beyond this, no? Crisis and lockdown, di ba, when we share our talent, the more that we become good at it. Now that also includes if you have the means, if you have the resources, no, share your treasure, no, the possession that you have. Yon, katulad kanina, ibinenta yung kanyang possession so that other people can be blessed. And that also includes, no, sometimes hindi ikaw yung merong resources, hindi ikaw yung merong pera. This happened to me. No, I have friends in Singapore, our feast, Singapore Orchard. Dahil may relationship na kami, nagtanong sila sa akin, bro, ano bang kailangan na tulong nyo dyan? Kasi meron kaming extra money, and I was really blown away. No? Yung extra money talaga nila is around 200,000 pesos. And, you know, fast forward to today, that was sent, and I connected them doon sa aming efforts ng para sa front lines natin, pagtulong rin sa mga servants, no, ng feast. And hindi ako yung nagbigay, but I became a bridge, o, di ba? Yung pagiging tulay mo, wag mo lang gamitin sa love life, love life, di ba? Pwede mo rin gamitin yan sa pagtulong ng tao. That maaaring may gustong tumulong, may kakilala kang nangangailangan, then connect them. Connect them. So share your time, talent, and treasure. And that's how you're going to have that kind of life that is generous, that is all-giving. And, you know, my dear friends, I want to quote this in the Gospel of Luke, Chapter 6, verse 38. Give, and you will receive. Your gift will return to you in full. Pressed down, shaken together to make room for more. Running over and poured into your lap. The amount you give will determine the amount you get back. If you want to experience an abundant life, an overflowing life, my dear friend, make a decision to become a giver. Because when you give, you cannot outgive God when it comes to His generosity. Ready ka na ba para sa siksik, liglig, at umaapaw na biyaya ng Diyos para sa buhay mo? Maaring isipin mo ngayon, umaapaw ang problema, but my dear friend, you can also focus on the blessings, and now that you discover these blessings, it's not just meant for you, it's meant to be shared. Tamang-tama rin ito, and I want to share with you 1 John chapter 4, verse 19, we love each other because He loved us first. Kaya nga, I've shared with you 4G. Gratitude, goodness, growth, generosity. Pero di ba, parang kulang. We're now in the 5G era. Entering into that era in technology. So that last G is God. Huwag mong kakalimutan na kaya ka makapagbibigay dahil may unang nagbigay. Kaya ka magmamahal dahil may unang nagmahal sa'yo. Si Lord ang unang first love mo. First love ko. First love nating lahat, si Lord. The reason why we can love, the reason why we can give is because God first loved us. God first gave His precious gift to us, His only Son, Jesus Christ. And that's why, my dear friends, I want to encourage you na hindi matatapos dito. Tuloy ang kwentuhan, tuloy ang pagbibigay, tuloy ang pag-ibig. And I want to challenge you now. Every day, ask yourself, pagising mo sa umaga, hindi lang yung magpasalamat ka. Diba? Your gratitude list. Hindi lang yung i-affirm mo yung sarili mo kung ano yung good sa'yo, goodness list. Hindi lang yung ano yung dapat ko improve, diba? That growth list. But that also includes, how will I give more today? And that's called the generosity list. Ano yung gagawin ko ngayong araw na to? Kahit isa, para mas maging mapagbigay ako. Sa pamilya mo, that includes also with your friends, people online, most especially during this time, how will I give more to those people that I don't know, complete strangers? How can I live a life of generosity? Let me end with this prayer that I am inspired because this is from our song, More Than Enough, no, sa aming feast na we always sing this sa closing namin, the feast OPM, overflow session. And we sing it, di ba? Oh, 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 I'm living in the overflow. Tapos merong part doon. I'm blessed, blessed to be a blessing. I'm blessed, blessed to be a blessing. Living in the overflow. living in the overflow. Let's pray. Let's come before our God who overflows with His love, with His grace, with His mercy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Panginoon, maraming salamat po sa lahat ng biyayang ibinigay mo sa amin, sa buhay na ibinigay mo sa amin, sa pag-ibig mo, Panginoon, most especially as we receive your Son, Lord, in our lives. Lord, nagpapasalamat kami kasi yun ang bumubuhay sa amin, yun ang nagbibigay ng pag-asa sa amin, yun ang nagiging dahilan namin kung bakit patuloy kaming bumabangon, patuloy kaming nag-move forward sa buhay namin. And Lord, this light that we have, the reason why we're still breathing, kaya pa kami humihinga, kasi merong dahilan. And we're not just going to say that, Lord, thank you, I'm blessed. But we're going to move. We're going to respond to your call. Send us, O Lord, so that we become your blessing into this world. So that we can share your love. So that we can shine your light. This is our prayer, Lord Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Everyone, take a deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. It's been a blessing sharing this with you, my dear friends. And I know, kung na-bless ka, become a blessing as well by not just liking, putting your comments, but also sharing this, making it also a viral, no? Virus na nakakabuti sa ibang tao. Once again, this has been Coach JC Libiran, encouraging you to step out of the dark, be enlightened, and shine His light to the world.